Introducing NVK Workflow 2, the latest installment in a comprehensive game audio workflow for Reaper. This suite of scripts is designed to make your workflow more efficient and flexible, allowing you to focus on the creative aspects of your project. Before we go into the new features, let's take a look at the basics of what's possible with NVK Workflow. With the scripts installed, when you add a new item to your project, take markers automatically get added for each variation in the item. This allows you to quickly audition different takes and select the one that works best for your project. As you add new layers to the sound, you can quickly make edits with the clickless editing scripts to trim, split, fade, and pitch items. Once you're happy with the sound, you can instantly create a folder out of the selected items, regardless of whether other items exist on the track. Folder items are automatically created in the parent track, allowing you to easily reposition or edit the items as a group. Rename the folder item with the rename script, which offers all kinds of advanced renaming possibilities. To make new variations, you can duplicate the items and switch to the next variation in the items with a single keystroke. The new variations are automatically named and numbered as well. Once you're happy with the variations, you can render them out with the render script. The render script offers a ton of options for every kind of workflow, and even allows you to specify different render settings per item. Copies of the rendered item get added to the parent folder, allowing you to keep track of the different versions in your project and also do quick edits as you might do with the destructive editor. If you decide you'd like to move the sound to a subproject, you can select the items and create a subproject instantly with the subproject script. With the basics covered, let's take a look at what's new in NVK Workflow 2, starting with the render script. NVK Folder Items Render Smart is a major upgrade to the render script, with an improved UI and a bunch of new features. As you can see, there are now settings for sample rate, fade in and out, normalization, limiting, and adding the render to the render queue. You can run Loop Maker on the rendered item as a post-render process, in order to create a seamless loop without any additional effort. Copy Directories allows you to automatically copy your rendered file to additional directories, as well as rename it, depending on your settings. Render Variants is an even more advanced option of this, allowing you to change your render settings too. It's great for situations where you need to render both mono and stereo versions of a sound with different names. Additionally, you can specify actions to run during the render process, allowing for even more flexibility. And as shown earlier, now you can specify different render settings per item. These settings get saved with the item and are loaded by the script the next time you open it. This allows you to have items with different render settings in your project and render them all at once. And the huge upgrade which makes the script truly shine is the ability to create render presets. All the settings you specify can be saved as a preset and recalled in any project. Next up, NVK Folder Items Rename has received a major upgrade as well. There's a variety of new and improved options for how your items get named. For renaming existing items, there are formatting options and match replace functions. And now a much requested feature, support for universal category system. The various repositioning scripts have been combined into a single script, NVK Folder Items Reposition. With this script, you can reposition items or groups of items and modify the positioning with scale, curve, or offset randomization. You can also save repositioning presets and recall them from the actions list. Let's create a preset to align groups of items by the item start, and another preset to align groups of items by their snap offsets. By running the preset actions, I can instantly reposition the items with the various preset settings without opening the script. It's incredibly flexible and can help out in a variety of situations. Now let's take a look at the script which makes everything possible, NVK Folder Items. This script has had improvements to performance, stability, and overall better compatibility with larger projects. There's also a number of new features which can be accessed with the settings script. But before I go into the new features, I'd like to quickly mention for those of you upgrading from Workflow 1, you will need to set up your mouse modifiers again since the scripts have changed. You can do that with the Mouse Modifiers tab in the settings script. There are a few new options for how folder items get numbered. By hovering over an option, you can read a tooltip to explain what it does. Now different numbering conventions, such as starting from zero or different amounts of leading zeros, are supported. There's also support for naming conventions such as UCS, which have the number in the middle of the name. And also, a feature I think a lot of you will be happy about, setting presets. Now you can create tabs for different setting presets and switch to them in your project. So for example, if you have a need for different numbering settings depending on the project, or if you need to disable folder items on a certain project, you can switch to the preset tab and then those settings will be used for that project. The preset tab you use gets saved with the project, so you can perhaps set it up once in a project template, and then you won't have to do it again. NVK Takes has also been improved. The script NVK Takes is now a constantly running script, similar to folder items. You can add it as a startup script or a toggle button in your toolbar. With the script running, when you add a new item or click on an existing item in your project, take markers will be automatically added to the item. This allows you to easily shuffle through variations with the next take script without any additional effort. So that's NVK Workflow 2. If you currently own Workflow 1, I'd like to quickly discuss the upgrade process. If you update to the latest version on Repack, you will be able to use all the scripts as before, with many of the upgrades I mentioned free of cost. However, if you try to use a new feature that requires an upgrade, you will receive a link to get the upgrade at a discounted price. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy NVK Workflow 2.